Reggie, Bob, Reggie. Yo, what's up, guys? Welcome back. Episode 2 of Jay's Guide to Gainz. And today, we're going to be cooking some scrambled eggs, right? I refuse to eat eggs any other way than scrambled. I'm a weirdo. I stick to the basics. When I find something I like, I keep it that way. But a lot of people ask even how to cook scrambled eggs, right? That's why I'm here. I don't cook anything crazy. I just cook the basics. But I'm here to teach you guys the basics. So, we're going to get into this scrambled egg mix here. So literally, it's going to take you less than 5 minutes. The first thing that you need is MCT oil. And the second thing you're going to need is Kerrygold butter, which is the shiznit. And then the third thing you're going to need is eggs. I have locally raised eggs. Fortunately, I have locally raised eggs because my sister has chickens. These are way, way healthier. It's mind-blowing how much healthier these brown eggs are than the store-bought eggs. Like the amount of amino acids you're getting, the protein, quality of the protein, all that good stuff. So if you can find locally raised eggs near you, for sure take advantage of it because it's going to make a big difference. So what I do here, I cook it on the power burner because I'm usually really impatient and I want to have it done as soon as possible. Power burner gets it done real quick, probably a little bit too quick, but it is what it is. I'm impatient. So I sprinkle a little bit of coconut oil in there or MCT oil. You can get this on Amazon. It's like 20 bucks. And the benefit of this is it just has a shitload of healthy fats. I'm all about the fats. Same thing with the Kerrygold butter, it's all really healthy fats, and it also gives you some more calories too. It's like 126 calories a serving, but it makes great for cooking. I know a lot of people use Pam, which is super processed, not very good for you, and then a lot of people use olive oil as well, which has like a low heat temperature, I think is what it's called. So basically when you start to heat it, it starts to break down and it's not as healthy for you. So the benefit of the MCT oil is it has a higher heat temperature or cooking temperature, something like that, don't quote me. But I know that the facts are there. It's just better to cook with, essentially. So once it starts heating up, get it around all around the pan, get it slick so the eggs don't stick. In theory, sometimes they still stick. Get it all over there, and then you're gonna start getting your scrambled eggs going. So it's always unfortunate when you get pieces of the egg in there and then you gotta try to fish it out, but I haven't quite mastered breaking the eggs without getting shit inside. So one, two, I usually go about 5 to 6 eggs. Let's get it off there so it doesn't cook while I'm breaking them. But I usually go about 5 to 6 eggs. It's like 400 to 500 calories. Oh, Reggie. Reggie loves eggs. If you guys got cats, by the way, that's why he's going nuts right now. If you got cats, cats love egg yolk. And they're really healthy for the cats, too. It really makes their fur shine, which you can see Reggie's got that shiny fur. He's afraid of the camera. But no, it's good for the cats. I even checked with my man Abe. He's a client of mine. He owns a couple of veterinary clinics just to make sure that it's not bad for him. Ooh, that one's not good. Sometimes you get eggs because they're locally raised that aren't 100% ready to eat per se, because these come straight from the mama. So you got to be careful. So what's that? 1, 2, 3, 4. So this is number 5. Boom. Alright, next step. Step number 2, once you get all your eggs in there, is to start scrambling them. So just take a simple piece here. Doesn't have to be anything specific. You can use a spatula, whatever. Oh, scramble the shit out of them though. It might get messy if you get a little crazy with scrambling. Make sure you really scramble it though to get the egg yolk with the egg whites. Reggie, chill bro, you'll get one when we're done. Just keep scrambling it. And this is what you're gonna do basically throughout. It's something I got from Chef Gordon Ramsay. He is the nutball that basically yells at everyone. I'm sure you've seen him on TV though, always yelling and screaming. But he said, this is the thing that he said, basically throughout while you're cooking it, you wanna take it off the heater and keep whisking it. I think that's the word, right? Whisking? I think it's called whisking. You want to keep whisking the eggs to keep them consistent, and then you put it back on the heat. Because when you take it off, it's still hot, so it's still cooking, just not as much. So keep on whisking all the way throughout the process, and then it'll start to harden up here in a second, which you'll see. Oh yeah, these are gonna be some fine ass scrambled eggs. You can already tell. Eggs are great, especially if you're on a budget. I mean, they're just so much cheaper than, let's say, like beef. Beef's probably the most expensive, or fish, something like that. But yeah, if you're on a budget, eggs are definitely the way to go. And also, don't let me see you eating egg whites. That is the biggest bullshit of all time. The healthy part of the egg is in the egg yolk. That's where you're getting all your healthy fats, your amino acids, all that good stuff. So whoever told you to eat egg whites is a fucking idiot. Don't listen to them. Don't waste those healthy egg yolks. It's absolutely ridiculous. So don't let me catch you eating egg whites. I know they sell them in the cartons too, by themselves, the egg whites. And I've heard those are not good for you. They're just super duper processed. Again, coming back to locally raised, that's the way to go if possible. So now we're getting somewhere. Take it off the heater. Keep it going. Don't want to get them burnt. That's the worst thing you could do, in my opinion at least. Some people like them cooked longer. To each his own. But for me, I like them right on the fringe of not being cooked enough, because I'm a weirdo. So it's probably about done. We'll let it cook in this warm pan for a little bit longer. Grab a bowl. Get the big ass bowl, I guess. So once you get your bowl, you need a knife. What you're gonna do once it's fully cooked, you're gonna take your Kerrygold butter. You can get it from Walmart. You can get it from really any grocery store, but Walmart's got the best price. It's like $3.50 a block. I literally put this shit on everything, which you guys will see in future videos. It's a total game changer. It makes all of your food just taste a million times better. And then also you're getting all those healthy fats too, so it's multi-beneficial. So before we do that, let's take the eggs, put them in the bowl. Boom, boom, boom. And then what you're gonna do is it'll show you on the wrapper how much a serving is, 1 tablespoon. I'm approximate with it. Sometimes I do a little bit more. Right about there. Take that, throw it on top, and then you just let it kind of melt through because the eggs are still hot. You want to get it all through the eggs. Now you just cover it up, the eggs, let it melt the rest of the way through. And then, last step here, move over here. Once it's totally melted through, still going. Before it melts though, something else I usually do obviously is bacon, right? Bacon and eggs go together pretty well. It seems to be a common thing, but bacon is just way, way longer to cook and it's way more to clean up. So for me, again, coming back to, I just wanna eat. I don't wanna spend an hour cooking food. I just want it done. So I usually just go with the eggs, but maybe in a later video, we'll do a bacon and egg segment. All right, looks like it's all the way cooked through now. Got butter literally on all the egg. It's looking good. Last step. I can't even describe how much better it is with the Kerrygold butter. Don't think you can get away without the Kerrygold butter, because, and don't think some other bullshit butter is gonna cover it. Telling you what, I used to hate scrambled eggs when I was younger, until I discovered Kerrygold butter and I started putting that on my eggs. And legit, now scrambled eggs are probably a top 5 food for me. That's how much it changes the game. Kerrygold butter, get it at Walmart. If you don't have a Walmart, which they're all over the world, you can get it online on Amazon, you can get it at most grocery stores, so check that out. There you have it, scrambled eggs. If you're interested in more food videos, this is early on in Jay's Guide to Gainz. We're going to keep rocking these. Like and subscribe my page. Leave a comment below. If you have any specific foods that you want to see, let me know. Peace. All right, now Reggie's going to get his turn. Come here, Reggie. Come here, buddy. He loves him some eggs. Well, I don't know if he likes them actually scrambled. He likes the egg yolks. What do you think, dude? Give it a try. Yeah. He's licking the butter off. Told you the butter is the best part. There you have it. Egg's so good your cats will eat it. Peace.